New at 6, it looks like science fiction, but it is real life. This local man is the first person in the world to feel sensations with a robotic arm. The groundbreaking medical technology that is helping him do that was pioneered here in Pittsburgh, and health editor Dr. Maria Simbra explains how this technology has the potential to help people with paralysis feel again.
You ready, Nathan?
Yep.
Here we go.
Nathan Copeland has a spinal cord injury as the result of a car accident in 2004. While he can't use his own arms to do this, he can use this robot arm just by thinking about moving it. Not only can he control the movements, but he can feel what's in its grasp.
Sometimes it's pretty natural, sometimes it's not.
This is possible because of this brain-computer interface. Implants in different parts of Nathan's brain that control movement and feel sensation are hooked up to the computer. The computer is hooked up to the robot arm.
Nathan has 4 electrodes that are implanted in his brain that allow us to record from single neurons that are firing as he thinks about trying to move.
Signals from the robot arm go back to Nathan's brain where it's perceived as feeling in his hand.
Sometimes it feels like a pressure, sometimes it's just a tingle. A couple feel just like a warm feeling.
This was the first time that this had been done in anybody, in a person at all, let alone someone with spinal cord injuries. I think it's just a technical success that we're able to do that. There's a lot of challenges with trying to stimulate and record in the brain at the same time.
The sensing part of the brain is in this strip here called the sensory cortex. The part of the brain that controls movement is in this strip here in front of it called the motor cortex. Now, the body is represented along these strips of brain, so you actually can identify parts that correspond to the arm and hand. The team would like to eventually make the system smaller and more portable to be used in real-life settings.
As a first step, he could control a robot that was potentially attached to his wheelchair to perform tasks that he's unable to perform with his own arms.
Of course, all this success has led to more questions for the computer to analyze.
We don't always move when we're using our arm. When you're picking up a bottle or holding a coffee cup, you're not moving very much. And what's happening is that you're controlling the force that you hold the cup with. And so we've learned how to figure out what the brain is doing when it's moving. We need to learn how to figure out what the brain is doing when, instead of decoding movement, we're decoding force. How hard are you grasping something?
He hopes this work will lead to a treatment doctors can prescribe to spinal cord injury patients. A highlight for the team and Nathan was showing off this work and shaking hands and bumping fists with the United States president.
When the president, you know, shook his hand, Nathan could feel that by us stimulating through the electrodes in his sensory cortex.
Nathan can only move and feel while the computer is hooked up to his brain. He will be in the study for 5 years.
And then I'm out, which will suck.
He enjoys the challenges.
My record was 22 and I got 23 on Tuesday. So that's one of those things, it's like, I could probably do better. Let's just do it another million times.
I'm Dr. Maria Simbra, KDKA-TV News.